بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. إن خير الكلام كلام الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أجارني الله وإياكم منها. There are people who are pleased with humiliation. They have no sense of honor, and therefore they will not struggle, and they are not willing to sacrifice. And Allah Azza wa Jal dishonors such individuals. Even if it was from the believers, even if it was from the Muslims, Allah Azza wa Jal refuses to honor the one who accepts humiliation to be his savior. In the authentic hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the humiliation will not be removed until they return to the command of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that is to fight in his cause. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا ينزعه حتى يعود إلى الجهاد. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. My brothers, it is saddening to hear what our brothers are experiencing overseas. Despite the long distances that separate us, we feel that they are a part of us. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى إليه سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The likeness of a believer to another believer is the likeness of the body. If one part of this body is afflicted, the rest of the body responds with high temperature and fever. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, understand that the statues that we were commanded to disbelieve in are not the idols made out of stone and clay only. You are only commanded to abstain from worshipping statues. And if you think so, then you're wrong. We were commanded to disbelieve in every deity that is worshipped besides Allah Azza wa Jal. Every deity, anything that is worshipped besides Allah, you were commanded to disbelieve in it. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. Whosoever disbelieves in a طاغوت is described that it is the falsehood, all that which is worship besides Allah. So whosoever disbelieves in that and believes in Allah, then he is the one who has holden onto the firm rope. The idols and gods that are worshipped today are rulers and governments that have subjected people to worship them, who have turned the lands into personal property. refuses to be this slave is considered to be the one who has committed the crime. There is not a Muslim land on the face of the earth today that has been left safe from this. Every Muslim land has been inflicted with this to a degree. And this is what you need to understand, that what we are seeing today is something that Islam does not accept and refuses, and it's your obligation to disbelieve in it. In the early 1900s, there were two personalities that rise: Stalin and Lenin. These two disbelievers came up with governments. From them is the Soviet Union. They are the minds behind it. And it was in opposition to religion. And what they came with was a replacement to religion. And I will explain to you some of their thoughts. Before I move on to explaining some of their thoughts, I will tell you that there were people working hard also on bringing such ideologies to our Muslim lands. And this was something that they realized, that it could be a way to control the masses. So there were two figures, Salah Bihar and Michel Akhtar. May Allah curse them. They went on to bring the thoughts of these two tyrants, Stalin and Lenin, and they introduced it to Syria. And they studied in the French schools prior. And they were sent overseas outside Syria to learn in the French institutions. And they returned to Syria. And when they returned, they started to preach these false ideologies and thoughts. And these thoughts looked like, to set so many people, so beautiful. Why? Because it sounds good. Wahda, hurriya, ishtirakiya. Wahda, unity. Hurriya, freedom. Ishtirakiya, socialism. And people at that time were under the French occupation. So they came into this land introducing this liberation, freedom, socialism, and unity. Of course, what they said is something contrary to what Islam calls to, because Islam unites people on the concept of belief. And it doesn't give the individual the freedom to go and sin and promote sin. Rather, it puts limits. Long story short, my brothers, these two figures, Michel Akhtar and Salah Bihar, they went on with time to form a government. This government, with time, it was called Hizb al-Ba'ath al-Arabi al-Ishtirak. It went through stages. Now, what they were calling for is to unite people under the banner of nationalism, under the banner of race, that the Arabs are one nation, Ummatul Arabiyatun Wahida, one Arabic nation, one Arabic nation. And they form this government. Now, what this government is based on is the separation of religion from life. So therefore, they do not accept any religion, no religion whatsoever, to be the source of legislation, especially Islam. And what they call for is freedom from all types of morality. So they were calling people to that which is sinful. under the banner of freedom. So to them, freedom is to be free from morality. And also the other was socialism, that all people are equal. Now from the time they took hold of the government, Syria has been affected, big time. But when the tyrant Hafez al-Assad took leadership over this government, he was on a mission to destroy Islam and to kill all that which would be a threat to his government. So he went on to destroy mosques. 10,000 mosques were destroyed in such a small period of time. And he went on to the Islamic institutions and he closed it down. They actually went into the Islamic University of Damascus and they killed the teacher and they imprisoned the students. And they were imprisoning in great numbers. And anyone who showed the signs of being learned and being practicing, they were executing him just for that. To the extent that they gathered over 1,000 students, over 1,000 students of knowledge, of Sharia, and they executed them all together. For no